kits on one side, test kits. Really, really clever, really, really put together.
Neat.
We know that something, oh, even with the sump, check this out, how it pulls out. Never seen a sump like that before. You get full access to the back, your skimmer, your socks, your return pump. Very, very neat. I'm not sure how they're holding up the weight of it, but stuff like this you only see in Europe. It's never seen anyone else do like that. This feels like it's made out of some sort of polycarbonate, the plexi, and really cool and fun colors. Typically in North America, you know, we're only seeing white, black, sometimes wood features. Very different styles. Everything's really, really shallow here. Lights that I've never seen before. Really cool. You guys hear me talk about this all the time in the store, the Vitalis food. We feed it to all the corals, all the fish, and they have now a new mixed reef food. How's this different than the SPS and the soft food?
So this targets all species of coral.
You're gonna hit
rather than just hard corals and soft corals.
You're gonna hit everything in one. You know that you guys have seen me in the videos. I'm always spot feeding the Duncans and the Acans with the LPS pellets. We have the NEM pellets. This is our go-to fish food in the store. We feed all the tanks this marine pellet right here. And I just got some interesting info. It's actually all made to a food-grade standard. So like he's showing me on the video here, super, super clean equipment. And not just making fish food, they have standards that they've met. It's made to a human-grade quality of food. So I already told him he doesn't have to sell us on it. We sell a ton of it. The grazers here. It's nice to see it in person today at the dinner. I don't know if I'm the only one in this regard, but whenever I see an empty tank, my mind immediately goes to how do I turn this thing into a reef tank? Even if it's something that's a stupid shape, this would not be very practical. The thing's got to be 3 feet tall. It would be a nightmare to clean, but my mind always goes to how do I fill that up? Even something like this. This company here does displays for stores. If you're looking to retrofit your shop with aquariums, a lot of, well, it's tricky actually. I built everything that's in the store by hand, but if you don't know how to do that, I guess you go to a company like these guys. Well, check this out. Everything is different in Europe. Very, very different. Everything is, it's hard to explain. It's like a different world. Love it over there. Lots of freshwater stuff. Look at these things. You're looking to build a new store. Incredibly rare koi fish.
Look what I found.
First display reef tank, and we'll spend a moment with it. Actually, it looks really, really mature. It must have been set up pretty recently. But it looks like a mature tank. Looks like it's been here for a while. The water's super clean. Very nice cleaner shrimp, gold coral. Look at the size of this guy. This is a German coral banded shrimp. He's not actually German. He just happens to be in Germany. Nice selection of some friends. It's nice to see this stuff, even though I'm on vacation. Looks very healthy. You've done a good job. I don't know what this tank is. It looks like a BioCube on steroids, very old school, but it looks cool, looks really good. Very healthy thing. Hello, firefish. Hello, torch coral. This little tom will be hanging up on top. I love these fish, but they hopefully SPS or not. I don't know if you see what he's doing there with that multi coral. He's pissing it off. Check out this rock. I'm actually in love with it. I think Tia would like it too. Quite safe in the reef rock. I don't know what it is. Super, super natural, ultra porous, natural colors, shapes. I'm not really sure if I have to get some more info. Probably they're ducky. They're place duckies here. Stuff like that is a little bit tricky, so if they don't have a Canadian or North American distributor, it wouldn't make sense for me to bring something like that in. It would be tricky. I need to bring in, you know, a container of something like that to justify the cost. It's kind of an issue with a lot of stuff here, so I'm seeing a lot of cool aquariums and getting ideas, but if they don't have a Canadian or North American distributor, it's not possible for me to order just one. The shipping isn't going to justify it. Something that I'm noticing about the aquariums here today is lots of different colors. We're so used to our traditional white and black, lots of wood tones, and that's something I'm really looking to do with our new line of aquariums that's coming out. I feel like the stands, at least North American stands, the ones that I'm used to, the black and white, it doesn't fit with all the decors. An aquarium is almost like, not almost like, it becomes a piece of furniture. It really is part of your home. Something like this is, it's a lot nicer. I think maybe it's just my personal opinion, but love, love, love all the different wood tones. The presentation here is immaculate. I'm getting a million and one ideas. I have some very, very, very cool dinners, meetings lined up for kind of looks like this, a little bit like this, but with an all-in-one filter.